Today I'm preparing some zircons for chemical abrasion prior to isotope dilution, thermal ionization, mass spectrometry. I have an optical image here that I'm taking live down the microscope. I also have a cathode luminescence map of the same zircon crystals. That map images the internal growth zones within the crystal interiors, and that lets me select fairly simple crystals for further analysis. To extract the zircon, I'm going to use this dental pick to place pressure on the epoxy mount, lever the crystal out of the plastic, and then use a tweezers to transfer it into one of these Teflon beakers. To begin, I'm going to put a small amount of water on the surface of the mount. That helps to keep the zircons in place as we lever them out of the epoxy. I'm now going to extract this zircon crystal, which has a very simple cathode luminescence pattern. To do so, I'm using a dental pick, placing it next to the grain, putting pressure on the epoxy, and then with a small twist, levering the crystal out of the plastic. I'm now going to use a sharp pair of tweezers to pick up the crystal and transfer it to a Teflon beaker with a small amount of water. I'm going to double check that the crystal released from the tweezers, which it did, so that I'm confident that crystal is now in the beaker. I finished loading my zircons into these small Teflon beakers. I've now brought them into the clean lab, and we're ready to load each zircon into a small Teflon microcapsule. Each one of these capsules will contain one zircon crystal. This is the container that we will do the chemical abrasion in, and then ultimately dissolve the residual crystal. I need to transfer the zircon, which is in water in this beaker, into the microcapsule for chemical abrasion. I'm going to do that under the microscope with a pipette that has a very narrow spaghetti tip. I have to find the zircon. Pipette it out of the beaker into the pipette. Discard the liquid into a waste beaker. Place the crystal in that little bit of water back in the beaker. And now I'm going to pipette as much of that water away as I can. I'm going to rinse the crystal with a small amount of dilute nitric acid. I'm going to pick that crystal up. Discard the acid, place the crystal back in the beaker, pipette as much of that liquid away as I can, leaving the crystal in the bottom. Add another aliquot of acid. And now I'm going to pick up the crystal in a small amount of nitric acid and transfer it into my microcapsule. I'm going to check that that transfer was successful by pipetting a small amount of acid in and out of the tip, making sure the crystal does not fall back in the beaker. For chemical abrasion, we use concentrated hydrofluoric acid. I need to add a small amount of that to the microcapsule, approximately 100 microliters. And now I'm ready for the next. Once I finish loading all 15 crystals into individual microcapsules, I'm going to place those capsules into this Teflon container bring that into the oven room and place it in the oven in a steel jacket at 180 degrees for 12 hours. During that process of chemical abrasion, easily dissolved portions of those zircon crystals, those portions that might have undergone lead loss, are removed quantitatively. It's 12 hours later, and we're now ready to pull the zircons out of the oven where they've been undergoing chemical abrasion. We've come into the clean lab, and I've very carefully cleaned any corrosion off of the outside of the Teflon liner. I'm now going to take the microcapsules out of the liner. We're going to dump the contents of the microcapsules back into these beakers that we used yesterday to do our initial washing of the zircons. And then we're going to rinse those zircons in the beakers, put them in the sonic bath, and then on a hot plate for 30 minutes each. This will remove the portions of the zircon that has dissolved during the chemical abrasion and leave us with a residual crystal that can then go on for dissolution. I'm going to remove the lid and rinse the hydrofluoric acid from it. Using my tweezers, I'm going to pull the assembly out, rinse it with water, and then disassemble. Discard that hydrofluoric acid and rinse, and set that aside for later. I'm now ready to transfer the zircon in each microcapsule into the corresponding beaker that we started the process in. The beaker contains a small amount of nitric acid that will dilute the hydrofluoric acid from the capsule. I'll repeat this 15 times, dumping the contents of each capsule again into the starting beaker. I'm just finishing rinsing my zircons after chemical abrasion. This beaker contains one of those zircon crystals that I emptied out of the microcapsule. I'm going to bring it to the microscope, use my pipette to capture the grain, discard the liquid, put the grain back in the beaker, and remove as much of that liquid as I can, recalling that that has dissolved zircon in it from the chemical abrasion. I'm now going to add fresh nitric acid. Again, pick up the grain and discard that liquid. Place the grain back in the beaker. And now I'm going to add about 12 drops of nitric acid, cap it, and along with the rest of the 15 zircons in their beakers, I'm going to place those into an ultrasonic bath. Turn that on for 30 minutes, and we're done. Following sonification, I put the samples in their beakers on the hot plate to flux for 30 minutes. I'm just pulling them off now to get ready for the final rinsing and reloading into the capsules. While the zircons are cleaning in the sonic bath and on the hot plate, I have been cleaning the microcapsules by putting 6 molar HCl in them, fluxing them on the hot plate, and now rinsing them with water. And discarding that. And leaving them dry ready to receive the zircon after I've rinsed it. We need to rinse out the nitric acid, which is inside the beaker with the zircon. Rinse it several times with clean nitric acid before reloading it back into its corresponding microcapsule for spiking and dissolution. I'm ready to do the final rinsing of the zircon. This is similar to the rinse that I've given them before. Picking up the grain in my pipette, discarding the liquid, putting the grain back in the beaker, pulling most of the liquid off, and then putting fresh nitric acid in. I'm going to repeat that step. Add one last aliquot of nitric acid. And then pick up the grain, carry it to the hood, and pipette it into the microcapsule. And the zircon in my capsule is ready to add hydrofluoric acid for dissolution. I'm going to repeat that rinsing for all 15 of the crystals, putting each of them into their microcapsule, adding the HF, and they'll be going into the oven at 210 degrees for 48 hours for complete dissolution. Before putting them in the oven, I need to add a spike. A spike is a mixture of enriched isotopes, including 235 uranium and artificial isotopes of lead, such as 205. This spike is how we quantify the number of atoms in our zircon crystal. I'm ready to start spiking my samples in their capsules. The spike is a solution of enriched isotopes, 205 lead, 233 uranium, and 235 uranium. They are carried in a dilute nitric acid, and I'm going to dispense drops of that tracer into each one of my microcapsules. We have to very carefully weigh the spike before and after in order to determine the amount of those isotopes that we're delivering to our sample. I'm going to weigh the spike bottle before dispensing. Record the weight. I'm going to dispense some spike into my capsule. I know that approximately 3 drops is the correct amount of spike, but I'm going to weigh that carefully. To determine a final weight. I'll repeat this step for each one of my capsules, which now will contain a zircon, the hydrofluoric acid that we use to dissolve it, and the spike. These will go into the oven at 210 degrees for 48 hours for complete dissolution.